I'm looking at you at the moment, Penny, you do scare me. You are the angel of death?
Yes, I'm not that scary.
You're not?
Well, I can be, but not today.
I'm pleased you're sitting that far away anyway, but you look lovely.
Thank you.
But James, you've written this the show. It's The Reincarnation of Trim Tab Jim.
Yes, congratulations on the pronunciation. People struggle. Trim Tab Jim.
Trim Tab Jim. I'll get it right, don't worry, eventually. This is on Saturday, December the 19th, at the Old Market Theatre in Hove.
Mm-hmm.
And it's actually for charity, isn't it? You've got two charity performances.
Yes. There's two performances in a day. The evening performance is for the refugee appeal, for the Red Cross refugee crisis appeal. And the matinee is a fundraiser for the Brighton and Hove Green Party.
Very much a charity.
Well, some people might consider it so. Yes, people are very welcome to come to either. Obviously, it's not just a Red Cross or a Green Party thing.
Okay. We mentioned that Penny is called the Angel of Death. I mean, is this a scary show?
There are bits of it that are... It's not completely frivolous, you know. It's a serious... It's essentially a reimagining of the final judgment. So at the start of the show, this protagonist gets brutally mugged and left for dead in the street, and then sort of awakens into the theatre, if you like, which has been reimagined as Death's waiting room, whereupon he meets the Angel of Death, who guides him through a process of reflecting on his life. And she soon helps him realise that perhaps some of his choices leave a little to be desired. And so the first half of the show is sort of personal. Can I just explain about the flat?
Yeah, please, yeah.
So as people enter, it's supposed to be immersive, so people, the audience members, are welcomed to Death Waiting Room, and they each fill out two questions as they enter.
I was going to ask you those questions for you, actually, aren't
I? Oh, wow. That would give the game away if I answered them. So, yes, the first one is sleeping aside. What three things have you spent most time doing? And the second one is, what three causes would you dedicate your life to? So in a sense, it's sort of like, what have you done and what should you do or what would you do differently?
Do you use this information afterwards?
Yeah, we use it in the show and okay. We use it afterwards as well, yes. Mm-hmm. It's really interesting what people put, actually.
Does this give you some ideas for the next show?
It would be a surreal show if we followed with some of the things that people put down. It really is from the sublime to the ridiculous. It's quite sweet, actually. Lots of people, for their causes, they mention people in their lives. They would live to make people in their lives happy. It's really quite nice.